yeah, brother. You're on the Please Me Fall on YouTube channel.
All right, ladies and gents, today is turning into much more of a day than we had originally planned. As you can see, we have Miss Ruby torn apart. There's a missing intake. James, why'd you have to do this? Tearing it down.
I had a giraffe put a hot tune in her, and next thing you know, the head gasket said goodbye.
Yeah, okay, maybe that did happen. So, as you guys know, when we were at the track and we went 862 or something like that, I don't remember the exact number, we pushed a little bit of water out of the head gasket, and it just so happened to line up perfectly that we had some Texas speed heads already on the way. So before we leave for Rocky Mountain Race Week, which is next week, we have to get these new heads on, because if we're doing head gaskets, we might as well put the new heads on. That'll flow better, make more power, and we're gonna need everything we can get, because we'll be up in that Colorado thin air, and the car might even run slower with the new heads and everything, because, you know, the density altitude up there is much thinner, much higher. So all the power we can get, we got to get. So we got these new Texas speed heads. They're going on Ruby today, as well as we're doing a map sensor that can read higher than 30 pounds of boost, because essentially what was happening when we were racing is it was just hit 30 and that was the max for the sensor, and I didn't know really how much boost it was actually making. So
making all of
it was making a lot. It's all crazy. Like, this is just madness. There's been so many little things to get this all together. All right, guys, check it out. There is one of Leroy's original LS1 heads that we had ported by Texas Speed. These things have seen it all, but this one's actually in pretty good shape. Came off of there clean. The pistons are, that's kind of funny.
Those are
things
for wiping them.
Oh, those ones. I was like, what the heck?
There's water fell into those holes, so I wiped them in it.
Yeah. So everything looks really good, though. There's nothing tore up on this side, but the other side, that's a little different. As you can see down here,
got a little droop in there.
Yeah, the head gasket is sticking out a little bit there in the middle. You can see a little crack, kind of like what used to happen on Leroy. You know, they've seen this before on this channel. Corvette with a blown head gasket. But this is the first time we pushed the head gasket out of Ruby, but she's got the, you know, she's got 4-bolt heads, so they're a little bit more susceptible to this happening in, you know, the 30 plus pound of boost range. We don't even run that much boost on Leroy, but he's a lot more efficient. So we're gonna get this other head yanked off. Hopefully everything is all right. And then we will open up the brand new skis.
Those boxes over there.
Hell yeah.
Waiting.
I'm excited. Damn, son. This thing looks great. Gosh, it's almost like a couple of professional rednecks built this thing or put it together, you know?
Top of the line built.
Right top here. Of the line. Golly.
Yeah, I heard the company built this motors about like 3 years back.
Back ordered, yeah. They got a lot of work. The whole McFarland Racing Engines, is they're busy guys.
Yeah.
Everything is super clean on this thing, guys. Ruby's junkyard block is still ripping. So time for some cleanup, time for some head gaskets. And this thing will be RTB.
RTB. By the end of the day.
I like it. Yeah, you can see here, guys, here's our head gasket firing. See how one of them's completely out of shape? Yeah, that's not good. It's all right. It happens. You know, we're out here letting her rip, doing it for Dale. What can you do? Well, you guys quit fighting. This is a workplace.
I'm trying to cut my shorts off.
You know the deal.
Brother, we're putting on these new Texas Speed heads, so we got them right here. We even got a new camshaft, because if you remember, we couldn't really rev Ruby too high. We kind of had to short shift her to get her to go as fast as we wanted. So this cam should allow us to rev up to 7,000 RPM a little better.
The anticipation is
Are
killing
you ready?
Me.
All right, hit it.
Come on.
Do it. Got the new safety cutter that we got in the fan mail.
Yeah, I didn't even go through the tape on that one.
Yeah. All right, let's see. Oh yeah, you cut the cardboard. Gosh, you're a savage.
Oh.
Hell yeah. These bad girls to give us that extra power we're gonna want on Rocky Mountain Race Week. Damn!
Dang, no more stock Sick GM it. Casting.
Woo.
These are their T20cc as cast heads too.
Yeah,
they're like a very sought after small bore motor, like your 4.8s, 5.3s, LS1s.
Yeah.
A lot of companies do these as cast deals with their thick deck aftermarket castings, but don't require a big bore.
That was kind of our problem, is the deck on those heads have been milled, you know, a couple times stuff, so it's pretty thin. This is a pretty thick deck. So
yeah, this is a 3/4 inch 10
degree.
Will help keep the head gasket in a little bit. Damn.
Going with CNC lines.
Holy crap.
You can see in the intake runners how it's
Woo.
The raw casting.
That is beautiful. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It's,
true.
It comes just like this, fresh out of the casting, which is like a flawless finish. It's really, really smooth and everything.
Damn. So huge shout out to our boys at Texas Speed, setting Ruby up with a nice pair of heads. She's definitely going to make a little bit more juice with these. Then over here we have their Athena head gaskets that Texas Speed has always used on our engines. Remember, this saved us when we were running that 7-second pass with Leroy, these little fire rings. Then we got our camshaft here. You want to just pull the spec sheet out so we can tell them what we got?
Yeah. It's a 228-232-600 lift on a 116 lobe center lobe separation, your LSA, which same lift as before, but the lobe lift and duration changed along with the LSA of the cam. We had a 114 in there before, and I think it was like a 222 or
interesting. Well, I don't know the specifics of how all that works, but they said we should be able to rev it a little higher.
Yeah. At which rate the valve opens and closes is your durations and your separations.
Cool. There's one of the old beaters.
Yeah, you can just see all the difference in like...
Yeah. That thing is shot. New PRC heads.
Like a 9.
Original Leroy heads. Yeah, so Leroy only ever went 9... Wait, hold on.
I think when we went turbo, we did away with these heads.
Yeah, so we did. So
he
only ever went 998 on those. But Ruby was able to go 86 on them. And then Ruby should be able to run 7s on these if the head gasket stays in. I mean, I don't know.
There's drain plugs to throw that water in here for a
Yeah, drain the water, run that 7.
See if you got the magic touch on the money shot.
You know I was born with the magic touch. Question is, did you put the fire rings in the right direction?
Of course I did.
Okay, I'm just checking.
All right.
She's on.
Don't put the runners on the wrong sides this time. These go up.
That's what we were joking around about last time.
Ugh. Dang.
That was so easy. Why is that so easy?
Perfect approach is why it was so easy.
Oh, so graceful.
Alright. Well, James is torquing that one down. You already did the main studs, so he's just doing the top ones. And we torque this one down. Start going back together.
Yeah, that was a short clip. You want to take it off and put it on a couple more times to make that clip a little longer?
It's steamy out here in Florida today, let me tell you what. My shirt can attend to that.
Yep, they can see your nips for sure.
So slow.
They're all moving. That's a plus.
Yeah, mine all seem to be moving as well. Dude, when it comes to an LS engine, we're some damn professionals. I mean,
it's like second nature.
It's so easy to put these things together quickly now. Especially the way this car is set up. Leroy's kind of a pain. This is smooth sailing.
Yeah, Leroy's got a lot more parts.
Yeah. Guys, check this out. Amidst working on Ruby and getting her ready to roll, we got a set of axles from the boys at G-Force Performance in the mail for Ruby. So we've had some issues with the axles that are in her currently. Not to worry, our boys at G-Force set us up with a set that we know are gonna be working well for Ruby. So we're gonna swap these in before we leave for Rocky Mountain Race Week as well. They're beautiful.
Those are beefy, look at them, Renegade.
Yeah. Think you can snap one over your knee?
Probably, let's give it a try.
Snaps your leg.
Hurts the leg.
Okay, and then right here we have transmission fluid for Leroy's backup transmission from the G-Force Racing transmission guys. And then right here we got something special from our friends at Carlisle Racing. I'm gonna put a link below to the Carlisle Racing YouTube channel. These guys have the fastest IRS car in the world, I think. Yeah, and it's a Corvette. Super cool guys, and they lent us some wheels to put on the front of Leroy that have some radial tires on them. So these radial tires are a lot stronger and will hold up on the road on a long distance drive, unlike the slicks that are on the front of Leroy right now. Yeah, those are way tougher. And they're on a set of V-Series wheels, so they'll match Ruby's front wheels. Oh, other side. Yeah, so those are right off of Mark Carlisle's race car, I'm pretty sure. Those will roll right up to Leroy. And then right here, we have some Mickey Thompson Sportsman SRs. We also got these from Carlisle Racing. You can order tires for them for any of your drag tire needs. And these will go on the front of Ruby, as well as we have one extra as a spare to have in the trailer in case we do have a blowout in one of the front wheels. We're gonna be set. These will be a little bit better than those bias plies.
Yeah. Well, you look at the tread then.
Yeah.
you get caught in, these are like a street tire, you get caught in rain,
yeah,
rain deflected and all that stuff on them. You know,
that's
you don't
good.
Have to worry about if you pick up a little nail or something. The tread depth on these are way thicker,
yep,
plus they're a radial compound. So
that'll be nice too, because if there's rain tire and we can like at least stay moving,
yeah,
that'd be better than just being stranded.
Yeah, for sure.
Boy, this thing's so easy to work on. It's the best.
User-friendly automobile.
Yep. So guys, we're going up right now. We're going to put the crossover pipe on, the McFarlane Fab turbo kit. Put the turbo, hang it up there, bolt everything down, and we already got the manifolds. I mean, the entire intake is done. Everything is like done.
Moving right along.
I mean, we gotta put oil and water in it once this turbo is on. And
after the world's finest turbo kit's installed.
Yeah, it's ready to go.
Wow. You really know what you're doing.
Just kidding, guys. We got a brand new cam, so I figured we'll use it for water first. And then we'll leave a little bit of water in it and fill it back up with fuel. You guys ever dilute your fuel with water? It lasts longer.
Especially ethanol.
Yeah.
Ethanol really likes water.
Lasts a lot longer. It's crazy. James has our specialty oil filler 3000.
Wow. Did you make that in shop class? How much do you charge for one of them?
This one here is a one-time payment of $69.99 plus tax, handling, and shipping.
All right. You guys heard it here first.
All right. Time to get this thing on its first heat cycle. What? What'd you guys do?
Cooper squeezed the hose, even had air in it, and it like shot a bunch of water out. It made a sound.
It was like, hold on.
I wanted to have it suck it in, but I squeezed it too aggressively, and it just...
It went bloop. It
sounds like a real blooper. So the only thing that we got to check here is we are running the same push rods that we had before. They may be too short or too long. It was, we didn't measure. So if it's loud, we need longer ones. If it's hanging valves open, we need shorter ones. That's the gist.
So science.
Science.
That's scary science.
We have a lot of push rods here though, so we could probably botch something together.
Just crank the starter for a while before you try to start it. Ignition off, yeah.
Ready? Yep. That sounds fine.
It hasn't been raining.
Yeah, I know. I think it's plus, so there's no oil in the lifter. So I'm, you know how I get a little nervous. Come on, man. Come on. You throttling it?
Yeah.
Wide open. Damn! See what we're
for the coolant temp. Oh, I just felt the fan kick on, hit my legs. All right, I think we're good. Boys, I think we're in business. Imagine that was Leroy, though.
Started at 10.
Leroy, we wouldn't have back together until probably 5 or 6 p.m., don't you think?
Yeah.
He's just a lot more finicky.
Well,
two turbos.
On everything, right? You know,
on this, yeah.
Wrench. Half inch.
Yeah.
Dude, that was awesome. Really good work, guys. So, all right, guys. Ruby is back together with her new head. So, we are going to dyno her before we leave for Rocky Mountain Race Week. At least that's the plan. We've been running out of time to do anything. No testing. So, we got some tire changes to do. We got to put the axles in. A lot of other stuff that we just going to have that we just got to knock out, get this thing freaking done. We got to do the other map sensor, things like that. Then it's time for tuning. Then it's time for Colorado. Really proud of Ruby. Oh, and she's getting her certification on her cage this weekend, as well as Leroy. So much craziness going on here, but we're getting ready for this week, and I think we're going to have a damn good time.
Oh, yeah.
It's going to be a journey. 1,300 miles in these freaking crazy Corvettes of ours, but that's it for now, guys. Thanks for watching. Do it for Dale. We will freaking see you later.